Hey Faith Family, it's Brother Mario. I pray you're having a wonderful day. I wanted to go ahead and create a video to share with you why it is so important that as believers we live a life as though Jesus was to come back at any moment. The Bible says, "No man knows the day or the hour in which the Son of Man will come back." No one knows exactly when. We can know the approximate season and see the signs of the times, but that specific hour and second, no one knows. But it's important for us to live a life as though Jesus was coming back at any time, any moment. Because if Jesus came back, let's say right now, what would he find you doing? Would you be obedient, helping others out there, feeding the homeless, the broken? Would you be with the widows and the orphans, doing the good works that God called you to do? Or would you be caught in sin? This video is to urge you to live by the Spirit so that you do not gratify the desires of the flesh and you live a life Spirit-led so that when Jesus comes back, he finds you faithful. I'm going to share with you two of my favorite parables, and they're found in Matthew. And so if you want to go ahead and follow me there, it's going to be in Matthew, and we're going to start in chapter 24, verse 36. Now, I just want to point out a few things here. If you notice in Matthew 24, this is where Jesus explains to his disciples the signs of the end of the age. They come to him and they ask him, "Tell us, when will these things be? And what will be the sign of the coming, of your coming and the end of the age?" And then Jesus gives them the signs. He also further talks about the abomination of desolation and the coming of the Son of Man. But where I want to focus in here is on verse 36. "But concerning that day and hour, no one knows." Okay, so no one knows when he's going to come back. "Not even the angels of heaven, nor the Son, but the Father only. For as were the days of Noah, so will it be in the coming of the Son of Man. For as in those days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day where Noah entered the ark. And they were unaware until the flood came and swept them all away. So will it be with the coming of the Son of Man." And so what he's explaining here is that the world's going to go on as it normally does. People are going to be partying, getting together. They won't have a clue. Just like in the days of Noah, they had no clue that the flood was coming. And so another part of the Bible talks about him coming like a thief in the night. We're not going to expect it. We're not going to know. And so that's why it's important. We can't know, but we should be ready at all times, 24/7, for his return. And that readiness gives us this desire for him to find us faithful. I don't want to be found doing gross, sick sin. I want him to find me faithful. So let's continue to read. "Then two men will be in the field, one will be taken and one will be left. Then two women will be grinding at the mill, and one will be taken and one left. Therefore, stay awake." Okay? So stay vigilant, stay on guard, because he can come anytime. That's what that verse is telling you. And that applies to Christians today, 100 years ago, 500 years ago, 1,000 years ago, or in the day of Jesus. When he resurrected, there is always this requirement or this wisdom to live a life as though we're constantly ready for him to come. "Therefore, stay awake, for you do not know the day when your Lord is coming. But know this," and this is the parable, "that if the master of the house had known in what part of the night the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake, and he would have not let his house be broken into. Therefore, you also must be ready." Okay, be ready for Jesus to come back like a thief in the night. "For the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect." Okay, so be careful to say, "Well, I don't think he's coming today." And I get that, okay? There are prophetic signs and sequences that need to occur that give us indication. I believe it's 1st or 2nd Thessalonians that basically says that day shall not come until the great apostasy, the falling away, and the man of sin, the Antichrist, is revealed. The temple also needs to be built, etc. So yes, there are prophetic signs, but regardless, no matter where we stand on that timetable, we are urged here to live as though we are always prepared for him to come back, because we don't know when he's going to come back. Who then is the faithful and wise servant whom his master has set over his household to give them their food at the proper time? Blessed is the servant who his master will find so doing when he comes. And so here we see a servant, and he's serving the Lord. So he's doing what the Lord has called him to do. And blessed is he when the Lord comes and finds him serving. Then it goes on to say, truly I say to you, he will set him over all his possessions. But if that wicked servant says to himself, my master is delayed, Jesus ain't coming back anytime soon. So this is a servant, someone who claims and professes faith in Jesus Christ, but is telling himself, yeah, Jesus ain't coming back for a long time, and begins to beat his fellow servant and eat and drink with the drunkards. So he's like, you know what? Jesus is coming back in a long time, probably not in my lifetime. So I'm just going to live like the world, and on my deathbed, I'm going to repent and make things right. Well, it's not a good thing for him. The master of that servant will come on a day when he does not expect it, and at an hour he does not know, and he will cut him in pieces and put him with the hypocrites. In that place there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And then he goes on in chapter 25 here to give us the parable of the 10 virgins. And this re-emphasizes again this wisdom that Jesus is trying to help us to live by, where we live a life in a watchful, okay, and I don't mean watching by going onto a mountain and looking up and like, all right, Jesus, you're coming every single day. I'm talking about living a life watching for him, meaning that I'm not going to allow myself to fall into sin, because when he comes back, I don't want to be found doing those things. Now, this isn't to teach perfection and that you got to be perfect. No Christian is perfect. We all struggle with sin. But overall, are you living by the Spirit? Are you producing fruits of righteousness? Are you a servant of the Lord, loving the broken and the hurt? Is this what the Lord will find you in that condition? Let's read the parable of the 10 virgins. Then the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Now, to give you a little bit of context, the Bible will say that Jesus is our bridegroom, okay? The church is his wife, and he's coming to marry us. That's why we have the marriage supper of the Lamb that was slain. Jesus, the marriage supper, we go into the kingdom of God, and we have a celebration, and it's going to be like a marriage. So the metaphor here ties into this. So five of them were foolish and five were wise. For when the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them. Okay, now the Bible says that God's word is a lamp unto our feet. And we see this analogy that oil is the Holy Spirit, living by the Spirit. And so five of them, they don't have the Spirit, okay? But the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, they all became drowsy and slept. But at midnight there was a cry, here is the bridegroom, come out to meet him. Then all those virgins rose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said to the wise, give us some of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, since there is will not be enough for us and for you, go rather to the dealers and buy for yourself. And while they were going to buy, the bridegroom came. And those who were ready went in with him to the marriage feast, and the door was shut. Afterward, the other virgins came also saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered them, truly, truly, I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour. All right, so this analogy, what I get from it is that And there's a whole bunch of different theological interpretations, and we could get into that in a deeper video, but I just want to keep it very basic here, that we as Christians, no matter what time period that we find ourselves in, these are instructions to us, wisdom instructions, that we live a life as though we are constantly keeping watch for his coming. We are vigilant, watchful, prepared. Don't get spiritually lazy, is what that is kind of indicating here. Don't think, well, you know, life's just going to keep on going on. First of all, you never know when you're going to pass. That could be tomorrow. That could be, unfortunately, by the end of this video here. I don't know. I could not be here tomorrow. Who knows? Nothing's promised. If the Lord wills it, we'll be here. But if not, we're gone. And so it's very important that we live a life this way. So I wanted to go ahead and share that because I think it's an encouragement that, you know, I know it can be a struggle with sin. Trust me, I know, okay? And it's not difficult. Now, keep in mind, we don't have to be perfect to get saved. Salvation comes by faith and grace alone. We receive the imputed righteousness of Jesus Christ by faith. And after that, he creates a new nature in us with new desires. And those new desires will produce the fruits of righteousness, of good works, of a transformed life. And so don't get twisted on this and think, oh my goodness, I got to be perfect for him to come. You're never going to be perfect until you receive a glorified body and you get into heaven. But overall, are you living by the spirits, or are you gratifying the desires of the flesh constantly? And if Jesus was to come back right now, would he find you living by the spirit or living by the flesh? Just something to reflect on. And maybe this analogy, this instruction in scripture can help you live a spirit-filled life. Have a blessed and wonderful day. Remember, stay vigilant, stay sober, and fear no evil.